Not sure what happened there, but we're inside of Hygieia. We're looking at the inner cover. We've got one small hive beetle there. Seems to still be alive. Don't want to be in here too long. Got lots of little bees looking up at me, but they're not pissed at me, so that's good. I just want to see the laying pattern, really, and then I'm done. I want to make sure there's a good laying queen, and then I'm out of here. It looks like I could probably wait a little bit and give her another couple frames, but it's not an urgent need right this very moment. Ooh, there's a lot of dirt and detritus on the hive bottom, but that's probably because that was a icky hive, so they just chopped it out. That's why they're so far behind, because they're chopping out all that old nasty comb. I think what I will do for their hygiene is take that old comb away from them. At least the stuff on the bottom. Not take that frame out, because they've already done a lot of work on it. I can just pick this whole box up if it's not propolized together. And yeah, that's what I'm going to do. Ooh, that's nasty down there. But look how nicely they've drawn that comb. And we've got some workers filling back in. Oh yeah, that's a nice, nice comb. That's a nice brood pattern. Not the prettiest comb. I broke it apart, but it wasn't the prettiest comb that went into it, so not their fault. Beekeeper error all the way. These are gentle girls. I like these bees. Yeah. Alright, they've propolized these two frames together. Can we see what's going on in the hive here? Maybe a little bit better if we turn it that way. There we go. This is the middle frame. This is where I'd expect the most brood to be. Oh, nice. Nice brood. They don't seem to want to supersede. So I'm just going to push this back together and show you what I can see on the bottom board. And we're going to scrape that off. But we're going to take it away from the apiary to do so. We're taking it in the chicken coop, as a matter of fact. Let them deal with any of the unhygienic factors. Alright, so we're going to take... There we go, that comes right off. How nice is that? We're going to sit them down here. Can you see all that icky detritus? Yeah, they don't need that. It's just going to attract vermin. So we're going to take this over here. Now we just got to get it level again, and we can close Hygieia up, knowing that she's doing well. There she is. She's got a nice laying pattern. Her bees know where home is, and now she has a clean bottom board. So that's much less likely to invite disease, hive beetles, any of that nastiness. She seems to really love her upper entrance, so I'm going to leave that. Look at them reorienting since I moved stuff on them. There you go, girls. There's home. That's home. Put you back together. And I need to come back in here in a week or so, maybe. See how they're getting on with that comb. Without further ado, let's go straight to Luthien. Take advantage of this brief moment of calm. Because we've had gusts up to 22 miles per hour today. So I want to get stuff done as quickly as possible. There we go. I'm mildly concerned that it's been 3 weeks since I moved her from the nuke to this eight-frame, regular hive body, for my apiary at least. So she might be getting crowded. And honestly, the other day I saw what could have been a lot of orientation flights or could have been the tail end of the swarm. Not really sure. So, let's go in and see. Hopefully I still have quite a few bees in here. Alright, let's get our smoker. Chickens are in sight. I was told by the wonderful mentors at the Metro Atlanta Beekeepers Club, that these ants that I constantly see, you see these ants? I hate these ants, are more of a problem for the beekeeper than the bee. But that doesn't mean I'm not going to scrape them all off right now. Who knows? Maybe they even keep the hive beetles out, because I certainly don't see any hive beetles on this. Oh, wow, there's so many ants. Seriously? These aren't a problem, huh? If you have any comments to the supportive or contradictory, I would love to hear them. Well, I guess the bees don't seem to mind, do they? Okay, so I have another eight frames of, I wouldn't call it partially drawn comb, but it's what I would cut comb out of. So there's a good starter strip of previous comb to show where to build. But now there's a guard bee. And it does look like they might need them all, because there's a lot of bees in here. So I guess now what I'm looking for is whether this hive is honey-bound, queen cells. Really shouldn't be queen cells. I mean, this is a fresh virgin queen. I mean, fresh, one month old, just started laying. Okay, I'm gonna need one. Frame lifter. Great tool. Solid brood on this side. No queen cell. Brood over there. Okay. I've seen all I need to see. Because all I need to know is that we've got worker brood to the outer frame, which means I'm going to put the inner cover on for a second. Just to keep the peace in the apiary. And I'm going to go grab another box. I will be right back. And I'm going to put my smoker up here to try to keep the other bees away. So as you may have seen, I melted a lot of wax and even managed to collect a little bit more honey from some stuff that was stored in my freezer. And from that, I got a bunch of frames like this that have starter strips on them. Can we see that? They're interspersed with, they're interspersed with blank frames. And so I can just take this box immediately, take the inner cover, smoke the bees down just a little bit so I don't squish too many of them. I don't know what happened to these bees here. Scrape them all off. I'm gonna put you there. Here we go. And the small hive beetle trap is still on here. Move this so we can slide it in. All right, we're gonna put it on at an angle now a little bit. There we go. Slide it over. Put it that way. So there's one small hive beetle trap back here. Make these nice and tight. Since this one has comb on it, this will be my outside frame. Can we see it? Yep, this one has comb, so it'll be my outside frame. I'm going to put some more Swiffer cloth here. And what the hay, here. And then I'm going to put her back together. And just for shiggles, I'm going to scrape this off. Just the frass from the ants. Put it back together. All right. For Lilith, I just kind of want to peek under her hive box, see how many frames she's covering. Gosh, I can't even see that. I want to take a look at Lilith. See how many frames she's covering. I'm really going to get the smoker going for Lilith because, you know, we've had issues with her. Alright, get some smoke in her top, in her front entrance. I'm going to go ahead and smoke Galadriel while I'm at it. Just so she's... just so she's aware. I really kind of want to open her hive entrance a little bit, but I don't know. It's not like it's really impeding their progress. They don't seem to be piling up at the door. Like, not a whole lot of bees up here. Just want to get the carcasses off. Right. I don't see a whole lot of bees in the top box. They're not absent, but they're not a lot of them. Oh, I see a lot of ants, so you see that? Ants on the Swiffer cloth? Okay. There's another reason to keep them. Oh, there's a hive beetle. I see bees up here, not a lot of progress. I don't see a need to go to stay in there. I know she's in and out. It's a windy day. We're going to be done with Lilith. She doesn't need a new box. I don't foresee a lot of problems. Let's check on Galadriel. This one's similar. We are just looking to see if maybe she needs another hive body. I don't think she will, but let's go see. There's more bees up here. Ooh. And a whole slew of ants. You see the ants? You see all the ants? Oh, yeah. The ants are clearly visible. Okay, well. If I need to, I have another 8-frame box I can put on top of this. But I'd rather string that one properly. Because even though I think I will be cutting and straining for all my extraction this year, I'd like to have the option to extract, which never really worked well for me with just plain foundationless. Oh, that's all glued together. A lot of bees. Oh, good. That's quite a few hive beetles as well. Okay. I just want to scrape off some of those ants. I can't stand the ants. It's too much for me. I think I'm going to replace some of the Swiffer cloths. I think I'm going to take some of them away for disposal and start over. It does not look as though... Yeah, they haven't drawn all their comb out. So let's do look and see how it's going. Kind of sludgy. This seems to be the first frame I see with bits of comb on it. They're rather annoyed with me. Here we go. Nice bits of new comb. Ah, and now I smell the honey, so okay. We have the answer here. Won't need another box for at least a couple weeks, I think. Well, maybe less if the weather holds. If we keep having 70 degree days and 40 degree nights, that's bound to make the sap flow really well. Okay. Regardless, we don't need to be in here any longer. So let's put her back together. Y'all are gonna let me put that back together without some paper cloth, aren't you? Alright. I'm gonna put one here and one here. Maybe that'll help with the ants too. Alright. So I think it's safe to say my apiary consists of 4 hives. I'm going to count Hygieia as a full hive now, even though she's not in a full hive body. But that concludes my brief apiary inspection for April the 18th. Thank you, and goodbye from the Aunt Wife's Garden.